Daz is an unboxing video for Tainted Grail Kings of Rune. Just got the box in the mail. It's not as big or as heavy as the ISS Vanguard box, but still pretty heavy. So let's open it up. Oh yeah, it's a bit heavy, but not too bad. It is pretty big. It's a big box. Now from the last update that they said, they mentioned that all the stretch goals are included in this one box, and it is a pretty big box. When I got ISS Vanguard and other games, they've had the stretch goals always separate. So this is the first time they've all been packed together. That's the side of the box. Well, the sides are a bit boring, but that's okay. And that's the back of the box. And that's what it looks like when it's set up. This is one interesting one to see. It looks like there's some cool looking miniatures in there. All right, I'm not going to read through all that. We'll go short as we go. So let's open this up. All right, and the first thing we see are these lovely tokens and things for your board. Okay. Oops. Might open those a bit later. So pop them in there. This is the rule book, fairly hefty, and a lot of components. Once again, not as many as ISS Vanguard, but still a lot. Introduction to characters, got a setup overview there, campaign setup, playing the game, exploration journal, core rules, what about the cards. It's very nicely laid out, this book. Over time, like, I've bought a lot of games from Awakened Realms, and ever since my first game I bought from them, which is Nemesis, you can see the improvement over time with all each game that comes out, each new one, in terms of the rulebook and the way they've laid out this stuff. It's so much better than it used to be. So they've learned a lot, but now they're a multi-million dollar company, and they produce some of the best games in the world. So some combat examples in there. But yeah, these books have certainly improved over time. A lot better than they used to be. That's not to say that they weren't, you know, okay, but these are so much better in terms of layout and the way they provide the rules, the way that you can learn from them. There's also apps available as well. There's online sites and stuff like that, and there's a rule summary in the back, which is good. All right. Oh, start here. I should have read this one first. Okay, unpack your models. Repair markers and tokens. So this tells you how to set up your first game. Okay. Unpack the box, play starting locations. First travel, so that's like how to get you into the game and how to learn how to play it. That's pretty good. There you go, it's all right. Oh, look at this. Okay, this is the Stretch Goal Exploration Journal. This here, Stretch Goals, box component list, all right. Setup, Straywood, all right, so this is like a, okay. Got all the various different sections in it. I don't want to spoil all that by lingering on pages or anything like that, because that's actually part of the story that you play through. Okay, so that's an exploration journal. Secret envelope, do not open. So I'm not going to open that. This is these are handouts. They're like letters and stuff. All right, these are save sheets. So they're like character sheets. Sort of like a role-playing game in a way, but not, because it's a board game. So they're save sheets for saving your game, and there's lots of them. That's really good. That's excellent. All right. That's a status sheet. I assume that you use this with saves. Expanded notes. And there's a couple of those too. That's pretty good. This is a... Oh, wow. That is a journal you can write stuff in. And it's got pictures. So a lot of the designer penciled pictures from when the game was first designed, the artwork was all designed. All right, lost chapter status sheets. I assume that is the lost chapter must be one of the stretch goals. Into the Mists progress sheet. That must be another stretch goal. I really can't remember when I ordered this game like a year and a half ago or something like that. So I can't remember what was in it when I ordered it. Anyway, these are player. This is a book of player sheets. Telling you what they do, what all the different characters do. I'll have to read the rules. It'd be good if once I read the rules, I know what I'm talking about. And that's the exploration journal. And I'm not going to open that up because that is literally the entire story. This means this is a game that you can play with many different characters, many different ways. Because you can keep going back and playing it again if you take different options, I guess. Or maybe I'm wrong, but yeah, that's what it looks like. All right, this is more foam. There's lots of foam in here to keep it all protected. They have fantastic inserts. And this is a lovely insert, which contains lots of the cool miniatures. We'll take that top off. These are your game boards, all packaged up. Okay, and you can put your little tokens and stuff in here, and little dice thingy tokens. These little tokens go in here to show what you're doing. Empathy, caution, spirituality, blah, blah, blah. The art is amazing. It's great. Fantastic. So they're the boards. You've got little plastic component-y things, which I don't know what they're useful, but I'm sure I'll find out when I read the rules. You've got, ooh, yes, dice. So a 10-sided and 2 6-sided specialised dice for the game. You've got these things, which are probably used for tracking, because there's lots and lots of them. They're thingies. Great unboxing, Steve. Good one. You can see there's lots of little plastic components. I don't know what they're for. I'll have to look through the book. But these miniatures are very, very cool. Very, very cool indeed. And what I might do is a separate little miniatures video just to show off how cool they are, because they look fantastic. Fantastic! Look at that. It's pretty amazing stuff. I don't know what they're called. Don't ask me what they're called because I haven't read the book. I've only just got the game. This is an unboxing, goddammit! That's some kind of fox thing, but it looks cool. Alright, so these are pretty good. So I'm not sure if these are for the main game or for the... I just lost something there. For the main game or for the extra thing. This is like a viewer thing which you can put cards in and it sort of gives you secret information. Alright, so what's underneath here? Oh, there's more miniatures! And 50 million bloody... We'll take that out of there. Cards, which this game is well known for. Whoa, look at that. Now these are tremendous. They're amazingly detailed. They would look fantastic if they're painted. I'm not much of a painter, but you know, one day I might rip these out and give it a bit of a go. Look at that. These dudes down the bottom. That's fantastic. I don't know how it goes back in. That's how it goes back in. Whoa, look at this one. It's because Jared's a bit small for him, but what the heck. Does that mean he's got no body? Or is that literally attached to the chariot, perhaps? I don't know. I suppose it does. It's a fantasy game, Steve. Stop picking things apart. It looks pretty fancy. Look at the size of the sword. Jeez. He must be overcompensating for the fact he doesn't have a body. That's probably why. Oh, okay. So these are all the cards that come with it. And there's lots and lots of these cards. Diplomacy cards. You are going insane cards. There's probably a few packaged in there, a few different types. Oh, look at that. Is that a bad dude? You must play at least one card during activation. This is the back of the secrets deck. So we shouldn't look at that one. Don't look at the back of the secrets deck. What's this one? Event cards. That's for chapter 9b part 5. Oh, these are obviously for the different sections. So you pick up the event cards, but link to the section that you go to in the book. That is the secrets deck. All right, that one is a encounter deck. That one is another encounter deck, and that one is a diplomacy deck. So you've got a couple of diplomacy decks, a couple of encounter decks. Over here we've got encounter. Let's top of the open play deck. What's that one? Yep, the art's really good. I love it. Lost Chapter 2, alright, and then you've got, that's event deck, a fancy event deck, you've got a combat deck, okay, I don't know how any of that works, so I have to read the rules, and then you've got these ones here, which are, and in here, I don't know how I'm going to get boxed back together now, I've thrown everything around, Place from Beyond! So these, you must lay them down like cards. So they form like a map, I'm thinking. Northern Pier, yeah. So these all sort of join together once you've got them all out and create the map. So it's like the map. This is like the board. Yeah, weirdness. And it's also got dudes on the back to fight. Well, that one does anyway. And that is Reflected Town. Yeah, so see how it connects to different cards? So you can make up a big map. I wonder if they gave us a map in here. Is there anything underneath? Probably not. Let's pull it out. Oh, there's two separate things. Oh, God damn it, I mixed them all up. Oh, well, that wasn't good. Okay, so these, I think you can... Ah, so these are like for saves, for when you save your game. And there's... Is that another one? No, that's just one. So that's a save game tray because it's small. You can tell that. And this is the other tray, which is just for storing cards and stuff. So I'm not going to take that because there's nothing beneath. Oh, I've got to sort these out now. So many cards. Later on, when I get a chance, I will split these all up and show them to you what they look like when they're all split up. For the moment, this is the unboxing video and it's all going to be short as opposed to my long videos because, once again, my son still complaining about the fact my videos are too long. Too long, he says. They're too long, Dad. Shorten them down. And I say, but son, the YouTube algorithm will destroy me if I have short videos. And he says, no, it won't, Dad. Just make them shorter. Does he really say that? Sometimes. Anyway, that is Tainted Love. That is Tainted Grail. Here we go. Kings of Rune. And like I said, I'm not going to open all these things up. This is just a basic unboxing video. Later on, I might come back and do a playthrough if I ever get around to that. Otherwise, it's going to sit on the shelf and won't break my shelf because of the weight. So there you go. I hope you liked that. If you didn't, go and watch a different video.